What's up, everybody? It's your boy Kato back again with our first mod video on the new whip. Alright, so of course you already know it, audio head, so I gotta get the audio done correctly because this car is straight trash on audio, dog. Straight trash, which is what I wanted because I already had my speakers left over from the Civic. So without further ado, let's go ahead and throw in the new my old stuff, but let's go ahead and start on the door speakers. We got, of course, you already know it, Crutchfield, they're the best in the game, and I already got the stuff for it, the mounting bracket, spacers, all that good stuff. So let's go ahead and let me show you how to do it on these. So I know there is OEM audio and a lot of people go with them, but I have leftovers, so for anybody that want either to upgrade to a crazy speakers, like crazy, like really good speakers on this car, which I don't know if people would like that because I don't know if they're as audio head as I am, but these speakers need to go. So let's get started. Right, guys, first step I'm gonna do is go ahead, take your spacer. So on these spacers, we're gonna use these clips. There's gonna be two long clips sticking out. Let me see right there. Those I just broke off because I fitted it. I already did one side. I'm just showing you guys the other side. So I fitted it, and this is what you're going to do. So the part that's sticking out is where you're going to place the speaker on, just like so. Just like so, you're going to place it, and then in the spacer, you're going to have these little grooves. You're going to match them up with the holes on the speaker. Once the holes are lined up, screw them in just like so, and this is how it's going to look. By the way, these are the C2-600X's. These are the coaxial JL audio. Great sound. I had them on the Civic for like a few days. But anyways, just like that. Now let's go to the door panel. All right, so now that we're on the door, there's going to be this little pick right here. I'm going to open it up. You can either use a fingernail, or I used on the other door a flat, really small flat, and go ahead and take that screw out. Just like that. Once that's done, you're gonna take like a little tool here, panel removal tool, stick it in here, and then kind of twist it like so, and then it'll pop it out a little bit, and then pop it out really slowly because these are very fragile. So go ahead and do that really slowly and then pop that out. And then there's a little clip up here where you have to pull it up and out. So like I said, you put it in here and twist it like that, and it'll pop out a little bit. And then be very careful with this part. Just kind of use your hand and slowly take it out. So actually, when I popped it out of here, I put this tool in a little bit and did the same twisting motion, and it popped it out. So now what I meant is you lift it up and you take it out because of this. Then you have two screws, one right there and one inside there. Once you get those out, you got this little piece right here. Okay, I guess you can just take it out with your fingers, just like that. And then you're gonna pull it out. Yep. Just like so. Once you take all these out, you're gonna start from this side right here. There's like a little groove here, and start popping out and go from the bottom all the way out, and then up here, you're gonna lift up. So once you start pulling, you gotta use a lot of force on this door. More force than the Civic. There's gonna be up here, so you're just gonna lift it up. Once you lift it up, there's gonna be a clip here. Let me show you. Just like so. Sorry. There's gonna be that little wire right there, and you gotta pull these out. In order to unplug this, I would use a flathead. Push on that while you're pulling out. So to pull this top part out, make sure it's in the locked position. All you're gonna do is pull up and pull up, just like that. So you pull up twice. Pull up, pull out, just like that. Now the door is completely free. All right, now that you're in here, you're just gonna pull this tab really hard. I had to use a screwdriver for the other side, like a flathead. So what I did is I pushed on this really hard, this lever right here, and then pulled up. And then you have three screws, one, two, and then three, and then you should just pull it out, be able to pull it out. I just wanted to do a quick comparison with these speakers. So this is a mid-range, so you're not getting any high out of it. I didn't want to mess with my other speakers because it's a big job. So I'm just replacing these. That's why they're coaxial, because I'm getting good tweeters with a good mid-range, and I'm adding a sub for the bass. So look at that magnet, huge magnet. Not bad magnet, to be honest, but I don't know, the sound quality out of these are not that good, but the bass is okay at the very most, and I'm just being generous. So definitely need to upgrade it, whether it's OEM audio or you're doing your own stuff like I am. Now we're gonna add these, but the cool thing about these, since on the stock ones the plug is on the outside, there's like a little hole where you can throw the wires through, and then once they're plugged in, this is the plug-in part is going to be on the outside, so it's pretty much going through, so it's going to be pretty good, you know, just like stock. Sorry, I can't find my words. Okay, so now I'm plugged in. Remember, positive is the big whatever that thing is called. Ugh. And then the negative is a small one. Or you can go white is positive, black is negative. Remember that hole I talked about? Comes out through there. There's the plug-in. So now you're just going to throw it into the card. Now that you got it screwed in, what I did, I routed the wire over here so I can get all the slag so it doesn't hit the window and there's no rattling. And then you're just going to plug it in just like so. Now that we got it in, what you're going to do, throw the door back on. First thing you want to do, throw the clip back on, and then throw these door clips back on. Just like so, plug it in, make sure everything's secure. Remember, we're gonna put the top back on first and slide it in, and then clip all the clips. Once the door's in, do everything in reverse, throw that in, screw these in, put that back on, and screw that back in. By the way, just a quick reminder, make sure this goes in first before you clip it back in. So you gotta kind of wiggle it until it gets aligned. Once it does, there we go. It'll go down, you just clip it in. Looks like that, we're all set. So let's go ahead and go for a sound test. Ooh, anybody know this, we gotta lose. 90s baby, but I get to that money like 86 again. Lost pops and fell off, we back rich again. Gotta thank God for that prison, be it music. Got us looking like the family selling bricks again. Been on tour, been on TV, all businesses. Send them pull up on you with that stick and flip the whip you in. You don't wanna hear about indictments in the case I put the bitch. Quit listening, free my Marty Anderson. I was in the county indigent, now my pendant lit. Bitches love me, they go crazy about that real nigga shit. Used to be a young follower. Me and my family wouldn't have food. Anybody go against me, gotta lose. 90s baby, but I get to that money like 86 again. Lost pops and fell off, we back rich again. Gotta thank God for that prison, be it music. Got us looking like the family selling bricks again. Been on tour, been on TV, all businesses. Still pull up on you with that stick and flip the whip you in. You don't wanna hear about indictments in the case I called the bitch. Quit listening, free my Marty Anderson. I was in the county indigent, now my pendant lit. Bitches love me, they go crazy about that real nigga shit. Used to be a young follower. Got me some type of way. It just a feeling this way. I do not know what to say. Yeah. And I know I shouldn't think about it. So one fucking look at your face. Now I wanna know how you taste. Usually don't give it away. Yeah. But you know I'm already thinking about it. Guys, and just like that, we are all set. I hope you guys learned something today and try it out for yourself, you know, instead of getting the OEM audio. This is a pretty cool alternative, and it was really easy. It probably took me like 30-45 minutes to do it all, so it's not bad at all. And just the only thing, I gotta figure out where to put the amps at. I don't wanna make like do any like modifications or anything. I'm thinking about under the chair, but I'm not sure. So if you guys got any ideas, leave it in the link below. So sound quality, just off of the without an amp or anything, I definitely feel more bass, and it's a lot clearer. Of course, it's more a whole of a sound, especially with the all the speakers working together. Even though they're shitty speakers with good speakers, but all of them working together make a pretty nice sound, a lot better than it was. But anyways, if you guys know where do I should where I should put the amps, let me know in the link below, and that should do it. Like, share, subscribe, do all that good stuff, and yeah. Spread love, not hate. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.